everybody, it is Emily for another episode of the Craft Corner. Thank you for tuning in. I hope you have in the past, and I hope you'll continue to do so in the future. Today we take a look at three very easy to do projects that will feature lighting for your backyard in the summer months ahead, as well as how to accessorize using your eBrush and my favorite Sharpie markers, and not only accessorizing, but how to update your wardrobe and maintain it so you can use it for many months ahead in the future. Without further ado, let's take a look at our new episode of the Craft Corner. I love variety, especially when it involves accessories. I found this pretty cool cell phone case at the dollar store and immediately thought of adding designs to the surface. I had an arrow stencil from a previous project and thought it would be perfect for the cell phone case. Placing it down on the case, I prepared my eBrush with a black Sharpie marker. Even after ensuring the spray was opaque enough, it took very little time to spray over the stencil design. After satisfied with the darkness of the pattern, I peeled back the stencil to reveal my finished cell phone case. Now I can make cell phone cases to accessorize almost any occasion or mood. Ladies, I'm sure this is a familiar sight for many of you. Driving a car can really do a number on the heels of our shoes, rubbing off the finish and leaving obvious wear and tear. I was once told to use nail polish or a Sharpie marker to touch up my shoes, but I was always hesitant it would leave scribble streaks. Now that I have my eBrush, I gave the Sharpie idea a try. The eBrush distributes a nice spray for full coverage without the streaks caused by coloring directly on the shoe. In less than a minute, I was able to touch up my boots and revitalize them for future use. Solar lighting adds magic to any outdoor event, so I decided to make my own lanterns with a glass bottle, solar light ground stake, and steel wire from the dollar store. The solar light easily pulled away from the base stake. To activate the light, the small tab needs to be removed. The remaining end will fit into the bottle, while the other end has the solar sensor. You can see the light activate when I cover the sensor, creating a false night effect. I secured wire around the neck of the bottle, twisting and wrapping to prevent the bottle from slipping. This wire will be used to hang the bottles in the tree outside. Using hot glue, I secured the lights into the mouth of the bottle to keep them from separating due to wind. When finished, hang your lanterns in a tree and enjoy the ambiance at your next outdoor occasion. Well, my crafty friends, that is it for this episode of the Craft Corner. Thank you for tuning in. By all means, give us a big thumbs up if you enjoyed the video. Leave us a comment. We always love comments. And make sure to subscribe to the channel if you have not done so already. Until next time, I hope you have a wonderful week, and we will see you on the next episode of the Craft Corner.